Those bow count, he holds them. They steady. And they're racing, and they were away in a good line too. Bow count from the inside bounce quickly, but here's the mare, Big Caroline, surging forward looking for the lead. Bow count is going to quicken up inside of her. Hall is rushing. Aragain around them just in front of Deputano as they work up into the first corner. So plenty of pace early. Racy Ava tucked away just behind those, followed then by Secret Pearl, Bollinger Boy a little wide then as they work up the side. Ukbar Ted followed by Sentimental Queen, Pink and Purple with 1600 left to go, and Harvey had dropped the Cat Ratcher back there to last. Through the next of the crossings, Bow Count going by the 1500, led the way and snuck a length and a half on Aragain when they sorted themselves out eventually. Over on the inside running third, Racy Ava, covered up by Big Caroline, who conceded the front when she couldn't get there in the early stages. Deputano is next in the middle. Tramping around it is Ukbar Ted, three wide, followed after nearly a length, Secret Pearl. About a length away then came Pink and Purple. Back on the inside, Bollinger Boy, second last, Sentimental Queen, and about to be joined by the Cat Ratcher. 1150 from home, out towards the river they head, and Bow Count is the leader. Hill tries to lock him down in front, led by more than a length, Aragain. One and a half away, running third, is Racy Ava over on the inside of the mare, Big Caroline. A length and a half to Deputano with Ukbar Ted and Secret Pearl next between those, then Pink and Purple. Well back still here at the 750 is Sentimental Queen on the outside of Bollinger Boy, and again relegated to last is the Cat Ratcher. So they head to the 600, where Bow Count still leads the way by a length on Aragain. A length and a half away on the inside, ridden along Racy Ava. The same can be said for Big Caroline. Still going forward after tramping wide all of the way is Ukbar Ted. Secret Pearl just held up behind them for Brown. He's looking for exit stage right coming into the corner. Deputano's got a beautiful inside run, however. And Pink and Purple to the outside with Sentimental Queen. Aragain hit the front from Bow Count when they'd levelled off. 200 left to gallop. Led by two lengths, Pink and Purple down the outside. Secret Pearl coming in the middle. Aragain joined by Secret Pearl. Pink and Purple. Pink and Purple and Secret Pearl. They'll split it. Give it to Secret Pearl. Secret Pearl narrowly from Pink and Purple. Aragain or Sentimental Queen, who leapt out of the ground late. Right behind those then from last is the Cat Ratcher, who run on. Ukbar Ted knocked up after covering ground, followed by Bollinger Boy. Deputano peaked on her effort as well. They were followed then by Bow Count, Racy Ava and Big Caroline amongst the last of them in. Secret Pearl's the winner. Jason Brown travelled easily to the home corner, just needed to get out, and then had to knuckle down and tussle it out with Pink and Purple, with Aragain clinging on, with Sentimental Queen putting a dive late there for third, just missing out. And behind those, Ukbar Ted, who compounded late after tramping deep. On as though here with Secret Pearl, who goes back-to-back, put the shades on the mare last start at Bunbury with great effect. But she'd been racing really well prior to that win, and goes back to back here for trainer Ricky Moss. JJ Brown aboard the So Secret Hayden mare, and it's win four from 19 over 10 Pink and Purple, ridden by Kira Yule for Luke Fernie. Third, number 7 Aragain, Peter Hall the rider for trainer Chris Willis. Fourth, 11 Sentimental Queen. A short neck and three quarters of the margins. 2.19.63. They posted for the 2,200, steadily run, 36.52, the last 600 there. But you could see that she was travelling really well for Brown. Coming to the home corner, he just needed to get out and find a bit of space. When they fanned, Secret Pearl capitalised and came through between Ukbar Ted, Racy Ava, and just kept chewing up the ground. Hauling in Aragain, holding off Pink and Purple, and Sentimental Queen diving late in that photo for third place. The Cat Ratcher got back to last, was pretty much back there all of the way, but certainly finished off the race quite well. The last here at 5.40, and Jason Brown has picked up the ride on Turbo Power at the unfortunate expense of Steve Parnham, who had that tumble earlier on today there with a suspected broken collarbone. So there's a lot more runaway stakes news to come from that event, I'm sure. Let's, in the meantime, go down. Scotty Embry is with us after this victory of Secret Pearl, who's doing a really good job in the care of Ricky Moss.
Doing a wonderful job. A winner on Melbourne Cup Day down at Bunbury. A winner here today midweek at Ascot. Now, Ricky, from time to time, you just need people out there to push you in a direction. And it sounds like for you, Sharon Miller's been a big help.
Yeah, definitely. If it wasn't for Shaz, I wouldn't be where I am today. And I'm grateful for her to pushing me into getting my trainer's license. So best decision I've ever made. And the proof is in the pudding.
Certainly is. Tell us about this horse and how you got a hold of her.
She was with a good friend of mine training her first. Didn't show a lot of ability as a younger horse. The owners wanted something, you know, that would race a little bit earlier. I did track work for their trainer. Thank you, Annie King. And she suggested to the owner that I would take her on and give her a go. And it's been a long path with her, but definitely rewarding. And, you know, I couldn't ask for a better horse.
She's showing a lot of staying ability now. Were you tempted to go and try a Saturday now?
That is in the sights, yes, so look out for her.
How many other horses do you have at the moment in work?
I've got another four in work. I had two trial really promising on Monday, so they'll have a start for me next week. You know, probably not as good as this one, but I'll give it a go to get them there.
Congratulations, well done.
Thank you.
There's Ricky Moss with Secret Pearl. Jason Brown turning back the clock. That's a pair of peaches he's given this horse, Michael, and we'll get a word from him very shortly.
Two rides for Jason Brown aboard Secret Pearl now for two wins. Brownie, were you in a spot of bother turning for home?
Yeah, I was a little bit worried. You know, I didn't want to peel off wide and come around. I preferred just try and find my way through the field, and the ones in front of me weren't quite taking me where I want, but luckily they opened up in time and we got through.
You rode this mare for the first time at Bunbury on Melbourne Cup Day, where you rode four winners, now two wins aboard her. Do you think she can measure up in Saturday grade?
Well, the one thing about she can stay, so if they stay, that's half the battle, isn't it? So, and she's got a bit of a turn of foot at the end, so she's probably worth a chance.
You've picked up Turbo Power in the last race at the expense of the injured Steve Parnham. Have you had a chance to have a look at that race?
Not a whole lot yet. We'll have a bit of gander in a sec, but I have ridden him a few times before and had a bit of luck on him, so we'll see how we go.
Good luck in the next.
Thanks, Michael.
There's Jason Brown and Ricky Moss teaming up with the mare here in Secret Pearl. 9, 10, 7 and 11 in race 7 here at Ascot. We'll be back for the last in 20 minutes or so, but our Sky Thoroughbred Central audience off to a break.
Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. I'm the man. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I'm the man. I'm the man. I'm the man. I believe every lie that I ever told. Paid for every heart that I ever stole. I played my cards and I didn't fold. Well, it ain't that hard when you got sold.